Hello people, welcome back. Andreas, I think you know is now third video, right?
Third video,
yeah.
Yes.
So this will be a part of this pickup video. And yeah, we got really good stuff here. And so just before we start, how you guys been? I know most of you is back into normal life again with after this COVID-19 lockdown that most of you in Great Britain has had. But sadly, I'm not back to normal.
No.
I haven't really worked since 2nd of April, or something like that.
Yeah.
I maybe have worked 10-15 days since then, and there's only been like 2-3 hours each time. So we still have the rule in Sweden that you're not allowed to have like more than 50 people.
In some places.
Yeah. So I work in a casino, so you can probably understand that we can have open for just 50 people. Yeah. We probably could have open anyway, but since we are governmental owned, it doesn't look good if we are opened right now. So I don't know when I'm going to start working again, but yeah. Thank God I have Andreas here that could we can do the pickups video with. I don't know what to start. Yeah, we actually went out on a... We don't really have good second-hand shops for video games.
Or regular video game stores. GameStop closed this spring.
Yeah.
So now we don't have any real video game stores
in
Sweden.
Yeah, we have zero.
Yeah.
The only place you can buy games now is like those retailers that sells like TVs and stuff
exactly.
like that.
Yeah. And they are like 10, 15
each
games.
Yeah. So we went on a little trip to secondhand shops and charity shops, and we actually found one game each.
Yeah.
And I found some other stuff as well that I actually wanted, so I was happy about that.
Yeah.
And in the future, me and Andreas, we're actually going to take, we think anyway, because Andreas is going to be tied up pretty soon.
Yeah.
He's becoming a father this
year.
So
in
before
December.
Yeah, in December, yeah. So before that we have actually talked about that we want to do a road trip and actually see those places that sell video games in this fucking country.
There's some stores that spread out in the country that we want to visit. So
And most of them are like across from us up to Stockholm in that span between there, because that's where the most cities are in this country. And most of them aren't in big cities, because in big cities the rent is too high.
It's too high.
Yeah, so they can't, economically it's not possible really to have it in Sweden nowadays. And so it's really sad.
Yeah.
We have to do everything online or Facebook groups and like you guys do as well. Yeah, so we went to what do you call this shop?
It's a second-hand store that you can buy games or magazines. Action figures.
Movies, a lot of movies.
And also some kids' stuff like puzzles and toys and stuff like that.
So in one of those places, I actually found a game that I wanted. And I think the second one and the third one is on Switch. I really want to get that as well. But I think, because I always like to play as a sniper, I don't know why, it's thrilling. You don't really have to be in the action, kind of.
It's not scary.
Yeah, so isn't there a Sniper Elite 2 and 3 on Switch?
Maybe, I don't know really.
Yeah, but the cool thing why I really wanted this one is because you can play with a sapper and like a light gun. That's always cool. So Sniper Elite, English. Everything is English on here and back, but inside the manual is Italian and Portuguese. I didn't see that when I bought it, but it was cheap. It was like £3-4, so it didn't really matter. And I also picked up a couple of CDs. I picked up more than these two, but I'm just going to show you because I think it's the two best trip-hop albums ever made, and one of them is actually top 5 ever for me. So I always buy them even though I have them. I don't know why. Maybe I wanted to, if I have people over and if they enjoy the music, I can give it to them. That's kind of the thought of it all, why I buy them again. So yeah, I just bought Portishead Dummy which it's a top five ever for me, and a Massive Attack Blue Lines. Do you want to go, or should I take them as well?
You can take your.
Yeah, and I was really happy to find a lot of. This is another thing that we don't have in Sweden anymore. Is video game
magazines. Yeah.
At least we think so.
No, there's none. Level. They stopped making those about 2 years ago, I think.
Yeah.
And there hasn't been a new one since then, so.
It's sad. It's really sad. Yeah, because in the 90s.
It's no physical media anywhere.
In the 90s and the 2000s, there were a lot of them, a lot of different ones. I mean, we can always buy the English one. What's the British one? That's really good. The retro. Yeah, you know, you guys know what I mean. But I found a few anyway. Nice to have in the Swedish bathroom.
Yeah.
And in Swedish as well. Yeah. And of course, I'm just going to show you. I basically took them because of the artwork. You know, Zelda. You know me and Zelda. And there was actually one that Andreas was in.
Yeah.
And I didn't pick that one.
No, it was too cheap. It was too cheap. He didn't want to waste £22 on a magazine with his friend.
£22?
£2.
£2.
Yeah.
£1.50 maybe, or something like that. Yeah, it's too expensive to put on him.
Alright.
Right.
So I also bought some magazines, but I didn't bring them today. But what I did buy was a game, and that's Prince of Persia for the Wii. And I had this game back in the day, and I really like all the Prince of Persia games for the GameCube and this one for the Wii. But mostly I bought it because it's a fun memory from our little trip. It's not often that we do these kind of things.
Yeah,
so when I saw this, I thought, yeah, I can buy this. It's a fun game and it's a nice memory of our trip.
It kind of felt almost like when we were out that I almost felt like I was forced to buy something because if we're here now, we have to fucking buy something.
Exactly.
Otherwise,
yeah,
it feels like a total mistake. But, you know, I was happy.
We went to four or five different places, and only two places had things that was interesting.
Interesting at all.
Yeah, so. But it was fun anyway.
Yeah.
And we got to eat hamburger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fantastic place.
Yeah.
So, maybe I should take one game that I actually got to yesterday.
Yeah.
And this is a game I wanted for a long time. I remember when this came out in... and I read about it and I really wanted it. And it didn't come out in PAL regions. It only came out in NTSC US and NTSC J. So, when this girl put up a post on Facebook that she wanted about 33 pounds maybe for a complete copy in the pretty nice nick, I have to say.
Yeah.
I'm like, I jumped on that, and that is Drill Dozer. And if you don't know, you have those Mr. Driller games, it's the same person or the same same series, but this is not a puzzle game like the other ones are. This is a platform game, and you have a drill. And it actually has different gears, the drill. And you can feel it because the cartridge has a rumble feature.
Yeah.
So usually just the cartridge goes for around 30 to 40 pounds. Just the cartridge. So I was super happy to get this for 32, 33 pounds, something like that. I'm not sure how the Swedish crown is now against the pound.
Like that.
But I think that's pretty... So I'm really happy about that.
Yeah. It's a fantastic game.
Yeah.
Alright, my next pick is Paper Mario for the Switch. And I actually got this as a birthday gift. My birthday was a few weeks ago, so my girlfriend gave me this. This seems to be somewhat a polarizing game. Some people like it and some people really dislike it.
Yeah.
But I've played it about, I think, 10 hours, something like that, 8 hours maybe. And I really like it. The battle system can be a bit frustrating, and it takes up a bit too much time, the battle mechanic. But the game and the artwork and writing is great, awesome. The graphic is amazing in this game. So I really like it, and it's nice to play a lighter RPG.
Yeah.
Not too heavy.
I heard that everything except the battle is top notch.
Yeah, if they could just change the battle mechanics so it would maybe be half as time consuming, this game would be a lot better.
So. Yeah. I don't know, maybe I get it. The only Paper Mario I really liked was the one on Wii.
Yeah.
But that was an RPG. That was more like a platform.
More like a platform.
Yeah, that's probably why I liked it.
Yeah.
New cap as well. This is my, when I first started playing video games, computer PC games, computer games, was with the Commodore 64, so I was really happy to get that. What else? Andreas put up a post on Facebook that he wanted to buy American DS games.
Yeah.
And this guy had two or three.
Yeah.
And you bought one, but you already had this one, so I'm like sneaked in there.
You jumped in.
Yeah. But yeah, it's okay to do that when you're friends. We need to help each other to find stuff, of course. This is Yoshi's Island DS. And this is actually a new game, right? This isn't...
Yes, it's a brand new. Yeah. Or was new when it came out.
Yeah. I always thought that this was the just a...
Remake
of the Super Nintendo version. Yeah. But no. It's actually its own game, so I'm really looking forward to that. And I thought I had it, so... Perfect Nick, American one, Yoshi's Island DS, happy to get that.
And I also have a DS game next. This is not the same, the one that I bought along with you, but it's an amazing platformer, Kirby-like game, Starfy. And I actually bought this on your recommendation because you really like this series. And
I think
you gave me the tip for this one because you already have the Japanese
one
version.
Yeah.
And so you said buy this, and I did.
Yeah, and I got all the three Game Boy Advance games for it as well.
Yeah, and there's actually more more Starfy games on the DS, but only in Japan, right?
Yeah.
This is the only one that's released in the US.
Yeah.
Which is weird because it's a great game. I've only played.
It's a very cutesy platformer, very Kirby-ish.
Yeah, very much like Kirby.
So yeah, definitely recommend that to get that.
Get it.
Didn't come out in PAL, right?
No, I don't think so. No.
Are we sure about this?
No.
Don't quote us.
Or what
happened
sure.
to the camera? So we have to be sure 60 minutes just so we can start it over.
Yeah, exactly.
So we're not stressed now. We can make as long videos as we want. So next two is something I've seen on everybody's pickup video. So this comes as no surprise that I got them as well. It's from Pixel Heart. It's supposedly the last fucking Wii U games ever. And that is Finding Teddy 2. And if Finding Teddy 1 came out on the Dreamcast, it was an official game, but it's kind of crappy point and click.
Mm-hmm.
And this is not point and click. And this is action platformer puzzle, much more, you know, for me. And the other one is the Shmup Collection. And I took off the sticker and put them on the cases because I wanted to. Yes, I got those two. So yeah, hopefully that's the last. No, I don't know why I say hopefully. I want more Wii
games.
What
about the Shakedown?
That's Wii.
But didn't they release it on Wii U as well?
American.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, I've got the Wii games from V Blank with Shakedown Hawaii and.
The other one.
But they are somewhere in the globe, somewhere. Yeah. Corona.
Customs are taking its time.
I don't know what the fuck's going on.
Alright, I'm gonna take one more before our current time is up, and that's Ys. How do you say that in English?
You say is, but I know the Americans say wise.
Wise.
Well, that is, and that is wrong, I think. I think it's is.
This is actually becoming quite rare. This is a JRPG, the 8th game, and yeah, this seems to be really, really good and becoming quite rare. I had to search a while for this one, so really happy to have it, and I'm looking forward to getting Origins and also the 9th game that's coming next year. So,
but the thing is with this one that maybe makes me want to get it as well, this is the action RPG.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. Yeah.
So I might get this as well. It's more like, what's that called?
16 minutes.
Oh, it's. Yes, we have to cut there and we'll come back.
Yeah, we'll be back.
We'll be back.
So we're back.
Jump cut.
Alright, so, but get this while you can, because I think this was, although it's retail, this is, was a very low print.
Yeah.
So this is getting expensive both in PAL and US versions. Yeah. So if you're interested in this game, after seeing this video or before, get it while you can, because I think in a year or so this will be quite expensive.
Yeah, and it's Falcom, they usually don't do any more prints, so...
No.
So, I think this is it.
Yeah. So it's happy to get one.
It's already up to like £40.
Yeah, I paid almost a new retail price on, for this one.
Yeah.
So, really happy to get it.
The other is Origins. I saw today that it's coming out on Strictly Limited as well. And much cheaper.
Yeah. So, I bought the Collector's Edition.
From Strictly Limited?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
And I didn't have to say it. I didn't even tell him. Talking about Strictly Limited, my most expensive game the last couple of years, Darius Cosmic Collection Arcade and Console version, way too expensive, very nice collector's edition though.
So beautiful.
Yeah, it's
Strictly Limited has the nicest collector's edition. All their boxes are pristine and amazing quality.
Yeah. I'm not going to show you what's inside there. There's a lot of pins and
random
stickers
stuff.
And you actually got a really nice book as well that is over on the shelf there, a big one, so it wasn't in this box, and it's actually one box more that is like a collector's piece, so I kept that as well. And it's you get a lot of games, and each of these games have like two different versions, so you're basically getting like 15-20 games, and I really like the Darius games. I think one my favorites are probably the ones I played on Darius G on the PlayStation 1. And I played on arcades as well when I was younger, so yeah. I'm happy to get it. I like shmup, so that was that.
Yeah.
I think I have less than you have. So you have to maybe take two now.
Alright.
Yeah. What happened?
I don't know. I'll take these two then.
Yeah.
I got these two today. I opened them here, so this is Pikmin 2 for the Wii with a new play controller.
And probably perfect time to pick it up because it's gonna get expensive because Pikmin 3 is coming out.
Exactly, so I already have the first one, I have the third one on the Wii U, and was it October 20th?
Yeah, we're gonna be stupid and buy it again.
Yeah, I think so, whatever.
Yeah.
And then I got this Lock's Quest for the DS, the American version, of course. And this is some kind of action RPG, Zelda style, with some customization that you can do. I haven't played this, it looks fun, and it was cheap.
Yeah. You can't go wrong with that.
No, perfect combination, so
Exactly.
Really happy with those two.
So the next thing I'm going to show is probably going to trigger some people, but I don't care.
Trigger warning.
Yeah, trigger warning. I like plants, and I like to have my plants in something that's maybe not supposed to be for a plant. So I bought two of these, and one of them wasn't working, so I thought, you know, let's make them for plants. So it's bongos for DK. For the GameCube, and it's dripping water now, I don't know why. Yes, I made it like that. hope you, some of you enjoy it anyway. Yeah, don't get mad at me as, oh, you can't use that for bongos.
I think this is excellent.
You had to fix them. No, I did that instead. Even if they didn't work, I would probably have done it anyway, to be honest. So
You're not going to play Donkey Konga?
No, I actually like the one that you're...
Jungle Beat. Yeah.
So I actually want... But I want the bongos with the box, the Japanese one.
Of course.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Just buy the rarest one.
Yeah.
Right.
Or the biggest.
Yeah, exactly. Next up is another Switch game, another JRPG. I'm not sure when I'm going to have time to play all these games, but this is how do you pronounce this? Atelier Ryza? Whatever.
Yeah.
You can see the game here.
I wonder how many games Atelier...
There's a lot, but the Ryza series, there's coming a second one next year, I think.
Okay.
Is the ones that are most highly acclaimed, how do you say? And this is the same situation as with the Ys game.
Okay.
This was apparently a very low print, both PAL and US. And so this is becoming rare already and expensive. So I'm going to give you the same tip as with the Ys games or Wise games to get it now. Because when the second game is here, I think this one will be quite expensive. So and I've heard a lot of good about this. So we'll see when I have time to play it.
Cool.
Maybe on my... parental leave.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the kid is sleeping. I heard exactly. I know a lot of people that's done that. Yeah. Played a lot when they were on parental leave. The next one, I really like this series. I probably never gonna be able to play it again. Maybe maybe I will get it on the Nintendo 64 though. Because the Rare is now with Microsoft. But I got Banjo-Kazooie and the He Holds the controller. Really nice, and it was, you know, new in box for like £20. It's really well made.
Yeah,
and feel how heavy it is.
It is heavy. Yeah.
You feel like it's not really tat, you know, like it's really
this
well
is solid.
Made.
Yeah, nice quality.
Yeah, and it got the Rare thing on the backpack there. I think it's really nice, and I really like Banjo-Kazooie. Never played Banjo-Tooie though, which is weird because I loved the first one.
Did you like the first ukulele?
I haven't played it yet.
Okay. Sorry.
I have so many games I haven't played. My God. That's why we, Andreas and I meet, so we can play some games we haven't played.
Exactly. Yeah. Alright, my next pickup is the DuckTales Remastered for the Wii U.
I want that.
And this is the American version, because the physical only came out in America. I don't even know if it came out in Japan.
Don't know.
It didn't come over here. So I got the American version because I like the cover and I like DuckTales. And I already have it digitally on my Wii U.
And this is the only time when Americans got horrible spines as well.
Yeah.
They got it. The Wii U games are white and with very boring. So finally we have something better than them. Yeah, but I want this as well, even though I can't play it.
And to match it up, I also got the original DuckTales for the NES, NES, in okay condition. I didn't really care. I just wanted it complete to match my Wii U.
Yeah, but you got figures as
well. Yeah, I get some figures and
I think that showed
stuff,
them in one video.
Yeah, so really fun games and happy to have them in the collection.
So I only have one thing left and you have
one thing left. Yes.
So I want to finish off with that one.
Oh, yeah?
It's okay if you take that big one as well.
Okay.
So this is the big one.
Yeah, so
heavy
this
hitter.
Is somewhat of a holy grail for me. I have been playing Fire Emblem a lot lately, Three Houses. I'm up to 80 hours now, playing it a second time. So I've been on a Fire Emblem craze lately. I bought a lot of the 3DS games and My most recent pickup is Fire Emblem for the Wii. And
very nice condition as well.
Yeah, it's really nice condition, but my god, this is getting expensive. So
can we ask how much you paid for it?
Yeah, I paid £90 maybe. Ooh,
to 1100.
Oh.
Yeah, expensive, yeah.
So but it's in really nice condition and I really wanted this, and I think this is actually one of the Wii games that I'm going to play in the near future, because Three Houses has been in my Switch for the last months.
Have you got the Fire Emblem for GameCube yet?
No, that's next on my list. So
That's even sometimes more expensive.
More expensive, I know. Yeah. Don't remind me.
So I'm so happy that I'm off the JRPG thing. Because otherwise, I can't love everything. Yeah, I love it, but I can't play everything. No. So
you can't get everything.
Yeah, so when me and Andreas meets, of course we can't, really play JRPGs, because that's not a thing you can do like for a couple of hours.
No.
So it's perfect that we like platforms as well. But he got his thing on the side and I got, shmups and stuff I can do when I'm, so you always have to find your
midway.
Yeah.
So I'm really happy with this, and this super is cool. Going to my Fire Emblem growing collection.
Nice.
That was my last one, and you also have a holy grail for your last one.
This is it's a holy grail for me, because I've been wanting this for ages, and I almost won one in an auction, but the computer at work stopped working when I was doing it. I had friends, beside me at work, and they were really like, "Are you getting it? Are you getting it?" And then I almost, broke the desk I was on.
Okay.
Because I was so pissed off. I'm like, because it was sold in such a good price as well. But this came up on a Facebook group, and Andreas told me, raspy fast. And was like maybe like £72.
Yeah.
And it's new, unused, in really good condition. And I got it today.
Perfect timing.
Yeah. And it's the chainsaw controller, Resident Evil 4 on the GameCube. And if you know these boxes are absolutely horribly made. And I'm going to touch it now, but when I'm finished in my bedroom and I put it up on the shelf, probably never going to touch it again.
Oh, it's really fragile.
Yeah, super fragile. Oh. But as you can see, it's a very nice condition.
It's like new.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks brand new.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
And the guy came to my apartment and, I told him, I'm the buyer. I should come to you. And he's like, no, it's okay. And he turned up and he was like very, I really hope it ends up in a good home. And when we met by that, he really wanted it in a collector's home and a gamer's home. And I told him, I got a YouTube channel that I had for like 8 years. And he's like, yes. So he was really happy that it ended up in my collection. And I think he's going to watch this video actually. So thank you, mate. That was fucking amazing of you showing up and... I didn't have to pay any postage, and it's in mint condition. Yeah. So, if you're watching, mate, thank you for bringing that to me for that good price as well. I'm super happy, and that made my day, supposedly. But we got something that will be probably on this video as well. But after this one, another day, I'm going to record that. But we got two more things there that's going to take a long time to unbox. So that's why we didn't do this in this part. So that's it.
All right, we made it.
Yeah, that was fantastic. Yeah. Thank you, mate. Or we should do it like that.
Corona.
So yeah, I hope you guys having a good summer. I'm having a very
relaxed summer.
But I can tell you, being off this much costs money, mate. Because if you're off like 100% of the time. Yeah, you want to do stuff.
Yeah.
And you want to do stuff.
Just getting out. And
yeah, so Netflix. Netflix really helped me. HBO, it's a lifesaver. And Andreas, of course. So I'm really happy that, we found each other through fucking love for games. So yeah, do you have, want to say something on there before we go? Yeah. What happened to your channel, by the way?
Yeah, yeah. It's on a break.
It's on a break.
I think I went in too hard to make it perfect.
Yeah,
and set the bar like maybe
super high.
8 levels above my head.
So, I've been doing this for 8 years and my, my videos are shit. He's like, his first video was like, whoa, it's like so much better than mine. So yeah, yeah. It's gonna take so much time, you're not gonna have that.
I did retakes and retakes and retakes and I just got sick of it. So
if I'm gonna be back,
I'm gonna do a more casual style. Yeah. But
he's definitely gonna be back on this channel.
Yeah, definitely.
We're gonna do more pickup videos and maybe something else in the future as well.
Yeah.
Who knows? And the road trip.
Road trip video.
We're gonna film that.
Yes, we are.
Probably October, November, maybe something.
Yeah, October, November, perfect. All right.
That's it, guys. Take care.
Be nice.
Hello again. Keeping the video going here. This is the day after, and like I said in the video, I think I said it anyway, I have 2 more things to unbox. One I already unboxed and showed to Andreas yesterday because there's a lot of unboxing of it on the internet. I'm just going to show you what it is. Both packages are from first 4 figures, so yeah, it's kind of awesome stuff. The first one came like this, and then it was packed in one another box. I mean, they packed it so well. And then it came in the next box, and as you can see, it's Luigi with the Polterpup from Luigi's Mansion 3 in this absolutely amazing box. And this is what you get. I mean, you can buy this figure on many places around the world, like in normal stores, and this is how you get it, and that's the collector's edition. But I wanted the exclusive edition. You have to order from first 4 figures to get it, like in that fantastic box. I'm probably gonna display him and the Polterpup above the box, because the box in itself is really nice. And it's numbered, and it's some other perks with the figure as well, and it's not so much more expensive really. Let's show the figure. Here you go. It's Luigi with the Polterpup. Perfect size, if you ask me. Super well made. And I don't know why I stopped playing it, because I really like it. Maybe I wanted to, you know, save the whole experience and don't do it too fast. I don't know. Haven't played it fast though. I never play games fast. But I think I'm like 60-70% into the game. And this is 2,103 out of 5,000. You can light it up like that. And that lights it up. And this is the vacuum cleaner. I don't remember what it's called now. You got a flashlight there where you flash the ghost before you suck them in, kind of ghost busty kind of way. Look at that, absolutely love it. So yeah, I've seen many unboxings of this, so I thought we don't really need another unboxing of it, so that's why I already done that. But the second one I'm gonna unbox here, I'm really looking forward to looking at this one. Haven't seen it really in any videos. Maybe there are a lot of them out there, but I haven't seen them. And let's have a look what it is. So there comes first in one box. Then it's another box that I probably have to save. And you probably saw what it is already. It is Zelda. And this time it's not Link. We have enough of Link stuff everywhere, and this is the best way they have ever displayed the character Zelda in any game, if you ask me. She's not like the damsel in distress. She's that strong woman that I really like, really cool, and she looks absolutely amazing, beautiful. So I'm really looking forward to looking at this one. And this is the exclusive version as well. So, box. Comes another box. Oh my god, it's so beautiful. So, so beautiful. Look at this box. Oh my god. Now I'm gonna have space for everything. I kind of wish sometimes I didn't buy the exclusive one because I need to display this box because this box is absolutely amazing. Look at that. Wow. Jesus Christ. Breath of the Wild Zelda. So you have to open it up like this because there's enough. Well, I'm not 100% sure where we got caught off, but I think it's about when I took out the last box. And here it is in its freaking glory. Zelda, the exclusive edition, Zelda Breath of the Wild. And I'm not gonna keep her in there, of course not. She's gonna get claustrophobic. Just wanna show you the box and how it looks. So we're gonna take that out. She lights up as well. The base module, I think, if I remember right. So many boxes to get up and open. See if we can get this one up in a good manner. Yeah, that was easy. She's so beautiful. And of course with the Luigi as well, we've got a cord that you can actually recharge your battery. Which are really exclusive one are rechargeable batteries. There's a cord. Oh my god, she's beautiful. And this is 3,940 out of 5,000. And there's two different things you can lit with it. I'm gonna show you first how she looks. Absolutely beautiful. You got the base, that kind of Sheikah art on it. And then you got Zelda herself, a fantastic dress. It's cool clothes, that wonderful hair on her back, swaying in the wind. She got a Sheikah slate in her hand, as you can see there. Let's turn her on. So we got the first one. No. Didn't light up. What's going on? Maybe it's not recharge your battery in this one. Yeah, it says recharge your battery. Do I have to recharge it before using it? Because it doesn't work. It's always something when I buy stuff. It's always something. There she is. I'm going to get it to work, of course. But yeah, absolutely love it. So, that's the end of this absolutely super long pickup video. Had a blast with Andreas yesterday. Just want to say in this video, thank you Andreas for last night. It was some great gaming. We finished New Super Lucky's Tale, and I think everybody owns, you know, if you got a console that has that game, get it. It's absolutely amazing. 2D and 3D platformer. It's a bit of both, and adventure game. And yeah, that's it. That's it for now. Be nice. Have a good time. And behave.